time. We have our noisemakers. Those on the corridor are not our fault. So it doesn't mean that you're going to go time or on time or anything. All right, next up, we have Kaimin Chun, Mario Skirgo, Ching-Yi, and speakers was the Zikas on cryptography with Dispensable Backdoors.
So, I want to start with a story, as you might have heard. It involves the FBI and Apple. So the FBI is the FBI, what it is, and the Apple produces smartphones. At some point, the FBI goes to the Apple, and it tells it, backdoor all your phones, so that it's all cracks. The Apple says, no, no way. Why not? I don't understand. This creates a big dispute. The Apple ends up explaining, because if I leak the backdoor to you, then anyone who gets it will be able to unlock all my phones. And that's a disaster. I cannot take that risk. And the question is, can this be avoided? So if you watch James Bond movies, you might think, yeah, of course, this guy knows how to do it, right? That's how. Very simple. Write your backdoor in one of those self-destruct machines. Only James Bond can hear it. The problem is that not only James Bond can hear it. Everyone and his cat can hear this tape before it's destructed. And then it's the same disaster. He has the backdoor. And I should say already that this image of a cat, I used the learning algorithm of Karsten from before. Right? So it works, that's evidence. All right. So the Apple has a solution, because next to the PIT, it has actually an Intel SGX processor. Right? What can it do? It can store pairs, key, and phone ID. And then upon receiving a message, here is my phone ID, it can spit out the key and stop responding. Fantastic solution, right next to the PIT. So if the Apple does that and produces such a smartphone, then locking is very simple. Just use that key to encrypt your state and throw the key away. Right? Every key, every phone does that. Only one phone can be unlocked, and that's it. What this gives us is effectively encryption, where we have a single backdoor, many keys. We can actually learn only one key and decrypt whatever is encrypted with it, and nothing else. The security of any other encryption is preserved. And in some sense, it's like a scratch of card backdoor, dispensable backdoor. All right, what's the problem with that? The problem is that this guy might get his hands on this Intel SGX, right? You know, a knife next to the PIT, it's not that hard. And then he can start doing all sorts of things, like freeze it, microwave it, disconnect the electricity, you know, toast it, put it in a washing machine, have Daniel listen to it until he figures out something. He can do many things. And this means that he might be able to reset it. He might be able to get another key out of it. So we'd prefer to be able to do it from stateless. So now the Apple has a problem, right? The Apple needs a way to create some information that cannot be copied or duplicated, right? Because otherwise I can just use it twice, can encode a bunch of keys, and can only be used once for one key, and then it self-destructs, which clearly is more than Jedi magic. Or is it? There is actually something that has exactly these properties, and it's called a qubit. And if you want to find out how this qubit is used for dispensable backdoors, our paper's on the imprint, and it will make this guy obsolete. Again, this picture is from Karsten's learning algorithm. Thank you.